do our jobs and execute at a high level. Obviously, it's the last chance we have to go out there and perform this week. But, I mean, everyone's excited to go out there and ready for another challenge.
Brooks?
David was talking about how you've, you know, throughout the season, you, on offense, y'all have just been trying to figure out who you are and kind of settled in right now. Where do you feel that is, and what that process was like trying to figure out who you were as an offense?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've kind of had to change identities a couple times throughout the season. As different players kind of get put in, as people get banged up, and we have to replace them with just different guys. So we've kind of been playing around with that all season. But I think the past couple of games, we've kind of started to find what we want to be, more of a balance between run and pass. Obviously, with the run game, starting to perform a little better later in the season. That's helped out a lot in the play action game and just spreading the ball around. So I think as long as we can do that and just be consistent on first and second down to keep us in manageable third down situations. I mean, I think we have a ton of talent on the team, and getting ourselves in those advantageous positions will allow us to spread the ball around a lot better.
And I know as a rookie, you wouldn't know any other season with the length of it, but, you know, a 17th game normally would be over at this point. You get another game in. How, as a rookie and even as an offense, you're talking about learning yourselves, what opportunity does it present you?
Yeah, I mean, like you just said, it's just another opportunity to go out there and get better, have a chance to perform better than we have in any other week previous. So we're excited for it, and we're ready to take on another divisional opponent that has a chance to be ranked or seated pretty high in the AFC. So we're going to try to go out there and do our best to stop them.
Mark?
Davis, given how you're progressing and you had a couple wins, but even though you didn't win this last week, and not to sound a little naive, but is it a little, you've worked hard to get to this point as a starter here. Is it a little disappointing that the season's ending now rather than maybe you have another chance or two to get even better?
Yeah, I mean, every week I want to go out there and play football. Obviously, though, I mean, it's been a long season. A lot of guys are banged up, and it'll be nice to get somebody, some people, some rest now that the season's coming to a close. But, I mean, like I've said in the past couple answers, everyone's excited for this last opportunity to go out there and perform and play the game we love in front of our home fans. It's nice that we get to finish at home instead of on the road.
Cody?
Hey, Davis, with one game left into the season, I was wondering, have you already started putting together like an off-season workout plan? And if so, what are some of those things you are actually hoping to improve on throughout the off-season?
Yeah, I mean, I'm still trying to figure that out. A lot of it's mainly focused on this last week, the last opponent, before I switch my focus to the off-season. But, I mean, I'm planning on staying here in the off-season, working out through our facility and try to get some of the rookies from this year and some of the younger guys on the team that we can build on to stay here as well, so we can continue building chemistry in the off season and come out next year and start playing really well at a high level.
Aaron Wilson.
Davis, what's it been like playing for this coaching staff, Tim Kelly, David Culley in particular, and Pep? What do you feel like your experience has been like this year?
It's been great. I mean, a whole lot of fun to start off. I mean, playing a game of football, and I'm out here doing my dream, playing at the highest level. So that's the first thing. And then, I mean, all three of those guys are great coaches and with a lot of experience and a lot of things that I can learn from. So it's starting to slow down. It was fast when I came in during OTAs and the start of the season, having to pick up the offense with all the new verbiage and kind of different things that were just different than what I learned in college, because I was in a little bit of a different scheme in college, being just like a true pro style old school offense at Stanford. So coming in the first half of the season, a lot of it was just trying to keep my head and learn all the stuff. But now that I've got everything pretty much ingrained and it's more week to week game plan stuff rather than trying to learn the foundations of this offense, I've really started to not worry too much about what we're doing, but more so what my coaches can tell me about the other defenses that we're playing and how I can anticipate better and really go on and attack each week, week by week, opponent by opponent. So it's been great.
Brooks?
You were talking about Sunday's game with Cooks. I think it was the The long pass with him, being able to check with him on it. You know, what with your connection with him, I think even your first touchdown was McCooks was saying, or I think you may have, that he had kind of reminded that the play was in there on that play against the Browns. What's your connection with him on how does he help your understanding of the offense? How does he kind of, what does he bring there, and how does that show up on the field and like at, in the facility as well?
Yeah, I mean, he's been great. I mean, to go back to even that touchdown against the Browns, that was a play initially for Nico, but Nico went down earlier in that game. But Cookie's reliable, and he can step in for somebody else at another position in the whole offense and execute somebody else's job if he has to get thrown into that spot. So, I mean, that kind of explains how he is for this team. Just extremely consistent and diligent in his work, and he's able to go out there and he's play at a really high level at any position on the field, receiver wise, because he knows the offense so well and can switch around spots. But I mean, he's been great for this team, great for the offense, and I obviously love going and throwing to him out there because he's a true weapon. And I mean, I don't think there's anyone on the other side of the ball who can stop him.
In recent games on the sideline, are there conversations y'all have about like things that he notices?
Yeah, I mean, that's constant throughout the game, different looks we're seeing, how corners are slow pedaling out, maybe he can get behind them on different releases or different routes. So that's stuff we talk about. It, I mean, in the week too, we're watching film together and talking about different looks and how we want to run certain routes in the game plan against their defense. So it's been continuing to grow together. That's been the biggest thing, and it's exciting. It's been fun.
Mark.
Davis, CBS showed a stat during the game last night, or Sunday, and I'm quite confident it hasn't changed. It's gotten even better, but it said you're among the rookie quarterbacks for highest completion percentage since 1970. You're right there with Dak Prescott, Mac Jones, Justin Herbert, Ben Roethlisberger. What does that mean to you, Davis, when you hear those names and you're right there in the middle of it?
I mean, it's pretty cool. Obviously, with the guys who have been in the league for a long time, have been successful. It's cool that just to be in that same discussion as them, and hopefully my career will turn out, say like Ben Roethlisberger, who just, I mean, played his last home game in Pittsburgh this last weekend. I mean, that'd be awesome if I could turn my career into something like that. But right now it's just go out there and attack each week and obviously make smart decisions with the football, because that's where completion percentage comes from. But ultimately just go out there and do my job, move the ball down the field and get our team in the end zone.
I know you'll reflect on this when the season's over, but maybe you could give us some thoughts now. What has it meant to you to get this opportunity so quickly in your career?
It's been great. Yeah, like I said, or like you just said, I didn't know I was going to get this opportunity as early in my career, but I'm extremely grateful for it, and I'm grateful for my teammates and this coaching staff and really the whole team here to put their confidence in me and support me, and I'm ready to go out there and give them my all each week.
Aaron Reese.
Hey, Davis, you kind of touched on some of it in terms of comfort in the offense now a little more and with your coaches, but what sort of benefit do you think continuity is in terms of just you being able to progress as a player with the offense staying the same one year to the next, coaches around you staying the same, those sorts of things?
Yeah, it's big. I'm not saying like you wouldn't have to worry about it, but just one more thing that is similar to the previous year allows you to put your focus on other things. Or more of your focus on other things. So it'll allow you to grow in different ways. With the same offense, you're able to do self-study on your own offense, but then also allow yourself to do more study on opposing defenses and just stuff from around the league to make your own game better, because you're not going to have to worry about learning a new offense and stuff like that. So the continuity is great, and I'm looking forward to it this offseason.
Last one for Sarah.
Davis, going back to your relationship with Brandon Cooks, I don't know if you came into the NFL maybe with an idea of how veteran players on this team might help you grow, but is there anything that he's done with you or conversations you've had that have maybe surprised you or just you didn't expect to get from another player in this locker room?
Not necessarily. I mean, I think coming in, you hear stories about how some of the best guys in the league, the top dogs at their position, are able to make all their teammates around them better. And that's exactly what Brandon does. So it's been exciting working with him and really just growing together and getting on the same page on different things in our offense because it's been fun going out there and being successful with them.
Thanks, Davis.
Thanks.
Aaron, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now. Sorry.
Go ahead.
One second. I'm not seeing the picture for the who am I speaking with?
Grugier-Hill.
I can see him now. John, apologize. Hey, John, as you head into the final game, what are the approaches of you guys as far as trying to finish strong and just kind of go out on a good note?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've done obviously not the result that we wanted this year, but I see we starting to make some trends and doing some things really well. That kind of is going to lead us into next year, obviously, getting used to the system. But overall, it's been good. So I just think there's the same mentality that we've been bringing into these past couple of weeks, playing with a little bit more fire and trying to finish these games a lot more. We're going to definitely try to do the same thing this weekend.
Brooks?
When as players, y'all were voting on, adding the 17th game, what were your thoughts through that process, and how is this, now that the moment's here, what did it kind of live up to your expectations about what it might be like?
Yeah, I mean, that extra week, obviously, as the players know, you feel it a little bit, but at the same time, it's just as if it's a regular, another game. I mean, we don't think about it in hindsight, obviously, with the preseason going down to 3 instead of it being 4. But I think that really hasn't changed too much. I mean, we just continue to just try to have that same game plan, the same routine that you do all season, so that way just for an extra week, you're able to still go for that as strong as you could.
And, you know, there is like, you saw that the NFL, like, part of that was, you know, getting, some extra money, extra push on that. What do you see on that and that share that, you know, y'all were able to get there, and whether that's worth what you guys are seeing right now? Because there's probably going to be more expansion in the future.
Yeah, I mean, then we'll just have to handle that when that time comes. But, I mean, I was a rookie last year, obviously, so I didn't know too much about it. I've obviously got a little bit more updated on now that I see it's going to be affecting us. But, yeah, I mean, I think we all collectively as a group has agreed on it, and that's what we're just going to stand by.
Aaron Wilson.
Hey, John, when you reflect on your season and some of the strides you made, how do you feel about some of the things you did individually, obviously? You know, the record, it's not what you guys want, but just some of the things you did as a player.
Yeah, I played solid. I mean, I think I've done – I can do a ton better, obviously, just going back and watching the film and technique and things of that sort over the course of the game, you know. And obviously just staying healthy and being available. I missed too many games this year, trying to make it through a full season so that way I don't have to have that tag on you, you know, things of that sort. So, it's always room to grow, and I think that it's just credit to the guys, to the coaches that have been around me. We've been just feeding off each other, just telling each other what we've seen in the game. You know, just different views from the game has helped us all out tremendously, and I think that that's just a hats off to my boys and the team for helping us out and putting us in the best situation.
And along those lines, John, what do you hope to do this offseason to come back next year and be even better?
Yeah, just making sure I get in a better routine, making sure I take care of the body, addressing things when I start to feel it, small things, and let it just get into to where I'm in complete pain, to where I want to say something about things. So just understanding, you know, listen to your body, and we're going to try to just make it through a full season and with the right results, obviously with the right mindset going into next year.
Last one for Brooks.
And again, on the 17th camp, I know some players, I'm not sure with yours, with, some players have incentives in their contracts and stuff like that. Does the 17th game help with that? Do they adjust on the other end? You may not even have that experience. I'm just curious about that.
Yeah, I mean, I've seen, obviously, on social media with the AB stuff, but I'm not sure about anybody's stuff on the situation on the team. I mean, it could not. I just don't know. That's just between them and their contracts and what the team and the coaches got going on for there. I know me, I'm on a rookie contract. Ain't no incentive. Right. So much.
I got you. Thanks.
Thanks, Sean.
No problem.
Hey, Kamu. get an award to give to you. You are the annual Pro Football Writer of America Houston Chapter Good Guy Award winner for helping us with our jobs and answer our questions.
Yes.
So thank you very much and appreciate you. And you're the good guy.
Awesome. Thank you. That's always a good rep. Appreciate that.
Yeah. And some football questions for you. You came back this past week. How did you feel out there? And what was your experience like when you first you get hurt and then you get COVID? How are you feeling? And just kind of if you could recap us and all that. Thank you.
Yeah, it was, I mean, definitely a rough 2 weeks. You know, I went down in the Seattle game. I thought the worst, but then once we got all the things, you know, figured out, it was, you know, praise God, it wasn't as bad. So, you know, I was working through that, and then I got hit with COVID. So, you know, the COVID kind of took a little toll on me. It took me a little while to get back. But, I mean, playing the game last week, moving around, felt pretty good. I'm excited to finish the year strong this week.
Brooks?
I'm curious from your perspective of back whenever y'all were talking about the 17th game, adding that, the votes by the players and such. I mean, what were your expectations at that point to now you've reached it now and what your thoughts are at this point?
I mean, as a player, I don't really see a benefit to it. You know, I mean, I think it's, you know, it's more for probably the owners or whatever, but I don't really see a benefit of adding a game. And I thought that before, and I still think now. So that's kind of where I stand on it.
And, you know, being in this week, I mean, what were some of the things that, you know, made you feel that way that you're now in that week?
No, you know, I think that, you know, we, like, unlike any other sport, really, we're the most physical sport, you know, and some guys, you know, some years you have years where you come out, you know, unscratched. And then some years you have, you know, certain guys in the locker room that are scratching and clawing to just stay healthy the whole year. So, I mean, I don't know. I don't think it was a very player friendly, you know, addition, but there's nothing I can do about it. You know, we're here, it's our future now, and we got to roll. So it's, you got to get used to it.
Aaron Wilson.
When you reflect on your season, best stats of your career, what do you feel like were some of the keys to having the season that you've had in terms of the opportunity and just in how you've played and grown as a player?
Yeah, I think, you know, just the opportunity I was given here. Coming in, we didn't really know what it was going to be. And, you know, I just didn't really care. Didn't care, you know, about the circumstance or where I was on a depth chart to start. I just kind of, you know, made my goals and just kind of made things happen. So I'm excited to, you know, have the year that I had. But, you know, there's I think, you know, I look back and there's some plays I wish I could have had back. And, you know, going forward, now that I kind of have this baseline of a year, I'm excited to, you know, build my, you know, I really believe that my career is just starting now. You know, I had a good start in my career with, you know, special teams. You know, I won a Super Bowl. And, you know, now being a starter, you know, I think my career is really starting right now.
We've asked a lot of guys about being under one-year contracts and this being sort of a proving ground opportunity. Your thoughts on, you know, obviously business is business, but at some point having a chance to sit down and talk with these guys about the possibility of coming back, is that what you would hope to do?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I love Houston. I love the team. You know, I love you know, we're obviously built, you know, we got things to build off this year. It wasn't, you know, the best year, but like I've said this before in recent interviews, like the bones are there. You know, I feel like we truly have the potential to build something special here. And I definitely want to be a part of it. So, you know, if we work through that, you know, we'll probably get closer to some stuff in the off season and go from there.
Aaron Reese.
Hey, Kamu, what do you think are some of the things you guys can build off this year, specifically on defense? Like, what do you think is kind of the next step for the defense next year?
I think, you know, we had a couple glimpses throughout the year of our defense being a pretty solid shutdown defense. You know, I feel like there's been multiple games where, you know, we would shut teams down for until like the fourth quarter, you know, so having those kind of glimpses and just building off that coming in the off season, you know, and and just having more guys buy into the system and really play the way that Lovey wants us to, and just kind of building off that, because you know, I think everyone can see the glimpses and the you know, the bright spots for sure. It's just now we just step it up and be more consistent.
As a player, for instance, do you feel when you're playing in a scheme for kind of the second year in a row?
What was the question? I'm sorry, you broke up.
As a player, what sort of differences do you feel kind of when you're playing in a scheme for, you know, consecutively for another year versus spent, you know, in your first year and learning?
Yeah, I think, you know, I mean, for the first half of the season, you know, we go through training camp, we go through OTAs. We're just learning the system. You know what I mean? We're not even really playing, you know, the defense as is. You know, every individual player is trying to just do their job and you know, okay, on this play, I have this, you know what I mean? But going into your second year, everyone, you know, that has been here and knows the defense, you know, we know the defense as a whole. We know what, you know, Coach Lovey wants. We know the holes in the defense. We know the strengths in defense. And I think it just allows everyone to play a lot faster. I'm excited for it. I mean, I hope I can be here because I think, you know, playing in the system in for multiple years would be unbelievable.
Last one for Cody.
Hey, Kamu, when we talked to you when you first signed here with the Texans, you always talked about it was your goal to play football in the state of Texas. So, mm-hmm. You know, is after what you experienced your first year, was it everything that you dreamed and hoped for?
Well, I mean, I wish we could have won a lot more, but yeah, everything outside. And, you know, I think, like I said, it's a great starting point. I love it here, and I definitely want to be here in the future.
Thanks, Kamu.
Yep, no problem.